Alright, my first video of 2024. To start things off, I will be doing my top 10 worst movies of 2023. Needless to say, this list is entirely opinion-based, so if you like any of these movies, that's great. With that being said, let's do this. Number 10. Meg 2, The Trench. Besides the climax, there was hardly entertainment in this movie. This film was just dumb, and not in a good way. Not helping is that there is hardly any megalodon action, and that giant octopus was underutilized. Instead, the film focused on these things called snappers. Oh, and the human villains were lame and forced. Number 9. Wish. I didn't want this movie to be here, but the more I think about this movie, the worse it gets. This film just felt empty and offered nothing new. Asha was just every other adorable Disney princess since Rapunzel, and there were way too many characters. This film should have been something special to celebrate Disney's 100th anniversary. Thankfully, we got the short film, Once Upon a Studio. Number 8. Justice League X Ruby, Parts 1 and 2. I'm all for crossovers, but this has to be one of the most underwhelming. First of all, why Justice League and Ruby? Yes, I'm aware they had crossovers in the comics, but still, I can think of many other IPs that are suited to crossover. This crossover is like Louis meets the Boys, or Frozen meets Jurassic Park, or The Godfather meets Finding Nemo. Oh, wait. Crossover choices aside, Justice League X Ruby was boring and the writing was lackluster. Number 7. A Really Haunted Loud House. The Loud House is a series that has overstayed its welcome, and this movie, for the live-action TV series, is another example. This movie was not funny, mean-spirited, and Lincoln was insufferable. If there is another live-action holiday movie, I think I'll skip it. The Loud House has proven its best days are far behind. Number 6. Ape vs. Mecha Ape. This movie is a sequel to the mockbuster Ape vs. Monster, which was already lame. While Ape vs. Mecha Ape is a slight improvement over the first film, that's not saying much. The film is still ugly looking, the plot is nonsensical, and the monster fights are boring. Number 5. Snow Falls. I'll admit, this film had a premise that could work, but the execution failed horribly. The writing for this movie was laughable, and the movie just got weird, and not in a good way. Like, seriously, I can't even tell what happened here. Number 4. Pasta Apocalypse. I love a good horror comedy, but this film is not one. The characters were bland, and the humor ranged from drawn-out skits to awful puns. Especially the pasta-related ones. This film almost made me sick of pasta, which I didn't even think was possible! Number 3. Winnie the Pooh Blood and Honey. This film was just a generic horror movie with the Winnie the Pooh IP slapped on. The kills were uninspired, and the film was just dark and bloody for the sake of it. As for the sequels, I have no plans to see them. Nor do I have any plans to see the Mickey Mouse horror movie, and I dread what children's IP will be next. Number 2. Cocaine Shark plus Cocaine Cougar. I merged these films because they are both Cocaine Bear mockbusters. Both of these films had laughable effects and were just boring. They are also misleading. Cocaine Shark is not about a shark high on cocaine. It's about a drug cartel selling drugs that will make you feel like a shark, with a shark monster wreaking havoc or something. As for Cocaine Cougar, it's about nothing. The film was just a bunch of things put together with no cohesion. While the film did have a cougar that was high on cocaine, it was hardly in the film, and could have been cut out altogether. Before we get into number 1, I have some dishonorable mentions. Indiana Jones and the Dial of Destiny. Rather than feeling like a proper send-off to the character, this film was just nostalgia without substance. 65. This film had a premise that could have worked, but it was ultimately wasted. I might do a video for it later. House Party. I heard good things about the original film, but the remake was boring and unfunny, except for the third act. Ruby Gilman, Teenage Kraken. Like Wish, this film gets worse the more I think about it. The film could have satirized the twist villain trope, but instead fell for it. Die Hard. Just a typical Kevin Hart movie. And the number one worst movie of 2023 is... Sound of Freedom. I know what you're thinking. Why is this number one? I originally sang high praise about it. Well, after learning some unfortunate things about the movie, I felt betrayed on a personal level. See, in 2023, I looked into the entertainment industry's long disgusting history of glamorizing and enabling grooming, which is still going on, by the way. So when I saw this movie, I was glad to have found an anti-pedophilia movie. But then I learned...
It was all a lie!
First up, one of the financiers for the movie was arrested for child kidnapping, and then the producer was exposed for groping a minor. Then there's the fact that the film's central figure, Tim Ballard, is very problematic. Like, he was fired from his own group for SA, and even the church broke ties with him. There's more, but these videos go into detail. Links will be in the description. When I learned the dark truth about Sound of Freedom, I regretted watching the movie. It is rare that a movie does this. So that is why Sound of Freedom is number one. Thanks for watching. What are your top 10 worst movies of 2023? Let me know in the comments.